Listen, paying for a graphic designer every time you want to create a awesome email promotion can get expensive really fast. That is why in this video, I'm going to show you how you can actually create your own email marketing promos, email templates, and email inserts inside of Canva for free. Kingdom Builders, welcome back to my channel. I am Ebony Evaughn, your favorite business coach in these internet streets. I coach corporate professionals and first-time entrepreneurs on how to turn their skills, talents, and expertise into profitable online businesses. Welcome to Soul Struggleland. This is my internet home where I help you to go from confused to the ethical cash generating boss that we both know you are meant to be. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to level up your email marketing game. This is the last video in our email marketing series, and this video is all about how you can create your very own email campaigns and email templates inside of Canva, okay? So the best way for me to actually show you how to do this is to jump on my laptop and go to Canva. So I will meet you guys in Canva, okay? All right, so as you can see, I am now inside of my Canva account, and we are going to create my 4th of July promo. So let's go ahead and get started. First things first is I'm just going to go over and click create a design. And for this email graphic, I am going to do custom, and the dimensions are going to be 800 by 1200, and then create new. All right, so for this one, I want to change the name. I always like to name. This is going to be like 4th of July promo, and then I always put the dimensions because sometimes I forget, and like if I copy something over, I want to know what it is. All right, so I'm going to name this. I actually just got done doing a Juneteenth promo, so you can see here this is actually my templates from Juneteenth, the sale that I just had. So I already know that I kind of want to use this template right here. So I'm just going to bring this in, and then I'm going to customize this to make it what I need it to be. So let me hit unlock on the design. I want to change this from Juneteenth to 4th of July. And I may change those colors in this picture, but let me just get my template together first. And then I want to change this right here. For Juneteenth, I did a special on my lunch accelerator, but for this one, I'm actually going to do a promo on my plan your year like a boss, since we're going into Q3. So let me find my email inserts. All right, so I actually have a template if you're interested in these email inserts so that you can just kind of plug and play, then make sure you check out the description in this video, because I actually have these included in the email boss bundle, and then you can use these to make like full sheet promos, or you can use them just as one-off if you want to just put like just this little square inside your emails. But I'm going to actually use this to build my template. So I want to get rid of everything that's in this section right here. I want to delete unlock that and delete, and then we're going to get rid of that, delete. Okay, so now I'm going to open up a new page because I don't want that to replace that. So I'm just going to hit add. And so now I'm just going to copy all of this, copy, and then paste it up here.
Like that. And then I'm going to change this picture. These are like my favorite pictures right here. Yeah. All right. Okay. And we're going to change this to by now. And I want to change this picture too. So I'm going to delete this. I'm going to delete all of that. And then I have a different mock-up that I want to use. And if you see these random pictures, just ignore those, because those are like pictures where I create graphics and stuff for my clients. I'm not like a crazy stalker or anything. Okay, let me find. And normally I try to organize this and put it in folders and stuff, but I haven't been doing a good job lately. But, you know, we'll get there. There it is. That's what I'm looking for. Okay, let me lock this because I don't want it to change that picture. I'll make this a little smaller. Move this over just a tad, about right there. All right, and then we'll make this a little bigger. All right, and then I'm going to cut all of this out. I'm going to delete that because I have something else that I want to add in here. Let me go back to my designs. And I'm going to add a client testimonial. I think I already have it done. Yeah, this one right here. So I'm going to go here and then hit replace page. All right. And then I'm going to hit copy. And then I'm going to paste it up here. And then bring it down. And the bottom third, like so. Perfect. All right. So this is what I want my graphic to look like. I actually want to bring this. Do I want that white space? Yeah. I think I'm going to leave it. So this is my graphic. So now that I have this done, I just want to actually export this. And then once we get this exported, I will show you how you can actually add this into your email service provider. So let's go ahead and download. I'm going to download this as a PNG. And then wait for this to download, and I will see you guys over in the email service provider. All right, so we are now inside of Mailchimp, and I'm going to show you how you can actually upload this and use this as a template two different ways. And I want to be transparent, guys. I have not used Mailchimp in, 4 years now? I believe I switched from Mailchimp to ConvertKit in 2019. I believe it was 2018. So right after this, I will show you how to use this in ConvertKit as well. So if you use ConvertKit, you want to skip forward, I'll leave a time step for you. But I do know that a lot of my clients and a lot of people that watch this channel use Mailchimp. So I wanted to make sure I showed you how to use this in there as well. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is hit create and then go to design email. Okay, and I'm not going to worry about inputting this other stuff because, again, I don't use Mailchimp. And for the purpose of this training, we just want to know how to get our design in there. So you want to click over here where it says design email. And I'm not familiar with the new builder, so I'm just going to go with the classic one for the purposes of this tutorial. And then from here, From here, what I want to do is just go to the simple basic template. All right, so I'm going to delete this logo block. And I'm going to leave this text here for a reason. So under this, what we want to do is add a block for image. We're going to drop that there, and then we're going to click for, I'll drag our image over here. Hold on, guys. I could have hit upload image. I guess I could have did that too, but I'll go to my downloads and then drop my image in there. All right, so I added this and you can see we have our promo in here. And for some of you, you may want to just have an image only promo for yourself. But if you do want to add text, that's why I left this here. So one thing that I might do is click here and then I may change this to say, "24-hour flash sale." Or I may say like one day only or a weekend only or something like that. And then I would change this little blurb down here to just be like brief description of email content or promotion, right? And then I would center these. And then that way you have some text up here, but you can just have this image only and then just delete this block. Or you may want to have like a little text at the top and then the graphic. You may want to add a button underneath this. Save and close. And then add a button. And that way you can add your link to your promo offer there. Or when you use these, you may be the type of person where you want to have, like, you see how you have these three sections here? You may actually want to include text in between each of these actual images. And how you can actually do that is basically you can just duplicate this. You can see I now have two of these, and then I'm going to click on the first one and then click edit. And then I'm basically just going to crop this down. I don't want to crop that way. I said custom. Hold on. Oh, that's why dimensions are locked. Okay, there we go. So I'm going to crop this to here and then save. And then for the next one, I'm going to click on my image. Click edit. And then crop off the top piece. All right. And so now what I can do is, let's say I want to add text in between here. Now insert text. Insert more details about offer, right? And so that way you can have text in between here, and then you could do the same thing if you wanted to add more text down here. You would just duplicate this box, click on the first one, go to edit, and then we're going to crop. Save, go to our last block, do the same thing, hit edit. And then crop it to our last third. Hit save. And then we can add more text here if we want it. And then more awesome details about offer. Great. And so that's how you can add text in between if you do want to kind of break those up. But if you also use those email inserts inside of the email boss bundle, you basically can do the same thing without having to do all the duplicating and cutting and cropping and all of that, because the inserts are literally just this section right here, just this piece or just this piece. So hopefully that is making sense. This is how you create your emails. Add your templates inside of MailChimp. Now let's hop over to ConvertKit and I will show you how to add your email template there as well. All right, so we are now in the new broadcast section where you can actually create your email. And one thing that I want to point out with ConvertKit is you'll notice over here to the side, it says I am using the new editor inside of ConvertKit, but you'll see here it says switch back to legacy. So if you are using the older version, this may be a little bit different, but with the new editor and ConvertKit, you will see it says general styles, and then you have your templates over here. And what a lot of people will do is they will try to create a template and then add their email this way. But as you can see in some of the templates that I have, that when you use the templates, there's actually this big white space in between like your header and the actual beginning of your email content and text, right? So I try to avoid using templates, and anytime I want to add a header or a promo graphic, I will typically just input it directly into the body of the email. So you can see here we have our blank email canvas and it says add content, and this is where I'm actually going to add my image. So I'm going to click add, and then I'm going to go to image, and I'm going to drag and drop my promo graphic over there. Your girl loves a good GIF in an email, so remember those. All right. And so if you wanted to send just the image itself, this is all you have to do. Add your image and then you can hit continue and you're ready to go. You can schedule it to send. If you want to add text above it, you can. So we can do our 24-hour flash sale.
So hopefully you found this tutorial very helpful and you now feel confident being able to create your own email templates, your own email inserts. Let me know below this video if you have any questions on how to use these templates. Now, if you don't want to have to start from scratch, then make sure you check out the first pinned comments below this video and you grab my email boss bundle. In this email boss bundle, not only do you get a masterclass on the ins and outs of email marketing, you get templates for emails that you can send in different sequences and events that happen in your business, but you also get my Canva template for email inserts where you can actually market your products and services. You can highlight blog posts whenever you drop a new blog, you drop a new video on YouTube, and you can also advertise your client testimonials, and you can create these email inserts without having to start from scratch. Again, that is inside the email boss bundle down in the pinned comment below this video. Thanks so much for stopping by my internet home. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on those notifications so you will be the first one to know when I upload a brand new video next week. I will see you in the next video, all right? Bye, y'all.